It has been a horror winter for the health system. Thank goodness we're in spring. Waiting lists long, hospitals overflowing, the workforce understaffed and demoralised, and above it all, there's been big reforms, enormous reforms taking place. So if the government changes next year, and remember the election is roughly 12 months away, maybe less, what's National going to do about it? I'm joined now by National's health spokesperson, Dr Shane Reti. Morena, kia ora rawatu. Thank you for joining us.
Morena, John. Good to speak with you.
Let's talk about Te Whatu Ora Health New Zealand. Mm-hmm. How's it going?
Look, I think they're struggling, which is a bit of a challenge when you think that they were announced 2 years ago. So they'd had 2 years to hit the ground running on 1 July, tens of millions of Ernst Young consulting fees. And yet the interim plan that came out a week ago said, look, we're not going to be able to fully deploy the health reforms for another 2 years. How can that be?
Is that the pandemic? Surely that's a pandemic.
No, pandemic can't be blamed on everything. And by the way, during the pandemic, there were choices. We could have built ICU beds during the pandemic. We didn't. And because we didn't, lists had to be cancelled, which partly explains the waiting list. So it is a contribution. Of course, I accept that. But there were choices that also could have been made that could have changed the situation we find ourselves in.
What would you undo? If you find yourself health minister in roughly a year's time, what would you undo?
So what the sector has told us is that they're exhausted. They're tired. And if we're successful and when we land next year, what they've said is please don't do major structural change. We're just too tired. And so what we've said is we'll land and we'll see what's working and what's not working. What I will undo is the Māori Health Authority. I will disestablish the Māori Health Authority for several reasons. First of all, an entity that in its establishment documents says that there will be no benefits in the first 5 years, I struggle with that. Māori are going to need gains a lot quicker than in 5 years' time. And when I raised this in select committee with presenters who came to the committee, and said to them, what are your expectations of a Māori Health Authority? They said, within the first year, we expect to be seeing benefits. And when I fleshed that out a bit more and said, what benefits? What would you expect? Nearly every single one said, vaccination, immunisation. I'd expect a Māori Health Authority in year one to be improving the immunisation rates for Māori.
Sorry, I want to interrupt then. So are you opposed to the Māori Health Authority, Te Aka Whai Ora, per se? Are you opposed to its very existence, or are you saying its performance is inadequate?
Several things. Its performance is inadequate, and as it's set up, is also going to create problems. There's a significant conflict of interest for the Māori Health Authority. So it's a commissioner of services, okay, so it purchases services, but at the same time, it's a monitor of Māori health inequities across the system. That is, it will be monitoring itself, it will be marking its own exam, and that conflict of interest was unresolved coming out of select committee. That's going to be a problem for
it. I want to go back to the National National Party health discussion document released in 2019. I thought it was a really good document because you laid out explicitly what you stand for. Now, this was pre the Aka Whai Ora, right? The Māori Health Authority. Māori Health, I'm quoting you to you. National will address the discrepancies in health outcomes faced by our Māori communities. Good for National. How will you do that?
Absolutely, and I will stand on those statements.
How will you do it?
Very simply, what we'll do is we'll have a Māori Health Directorate inside the Ministry of Health. And when I look last when a Māori Health
Directorate... Sorry, what does that mean? What does
that even mean? Oh, it's a strategic directorate inside the ministry, setting strategy. And if we look back to when that was last effective, that was in Tariana Tūria's hands. And that wonderful document here, Kore Wai Oranga, which really set Māori health strategy, that was the last time, in my view, we saw a really effective Māori Health Directorate that made changes.
So, do you have an issue with Te Aka Whai Ora per se? Do you oppose what we might describe as the co-governance aspect of it? Do you oppose a by Māori, for Māori, separate Māori health entity?
I do not oppose by Māori, for Māori, but that entity needs to be inside of one health system.
Why?
Because what we know is that the benefits are inside one health system, and what we also know is that the...
Sorry to interrupt, but what benefits? Let's talk about Māori life expectancy. What's the difference between your life expectancy and my life expectancy? Let's go in and see two newborn babies today up the road at Auckland Hospital, which would be a pretty lovely thing to do. One is Māori, one is Pākehā. Explain to the Māori child, the Māori baby, why his or her life expectancy is 7 years shorter than the Pākehā baby.
And so this talks to why exactly those co-determinants of health primarily, because let's be clear, that's actually the things that will change Māori health outcomes. It's not actually a Māori health authority. It'll be income, it'll be employment, it'll be education, it'll be housing. That's actually what's going to change that child's outcome. But the inequities for Māori around cancer and around cardiac disease, they have an acuteness. They need to be addressed here now.
And how do we address them?
Oh, we address them inside of a Māori Health Directorate, inside the Ministry of Health. It's what worked in the past to some degree. We need to do better, I get that. I don't disagree with the inequities. I've published on them, for goodness sake. I agree with them, but I disagree with the pathway towards them.
Why aren't we, and I've asked the Prime Minister this question many times when I was interviewing her on Breakfast, why aren't we angrier about this stuff? Isn't it strange we live in a country, and strange isn't strong enough as a word, isn't it terrible where we live in a country where the Indigenous people have a 7-year shorter life expectancy than people who look like me? Why aren't we sadder, angrier, more upset about that and more determined to do something about it?
It's a good question, and I want to shout out to the Māori Health research people, Paparangi, for example, who bring this information forward. Whether we give that enough voice, and therefore with enough voice comes enough resources and attention, that's a matter that we need to work on. But your point is well made. This in a first world country, to have these sort of inequities is unacceptable.
So what would National do about it? It's not just a directorate in the Ministry of Health, isn't it? Is that it?
It needs strategic direction inside the Ministry of Health to actually address these inequities. It needs several things also. It needs targets. It needs accountability. It needs a range of things, and that is best delivered from a strategic directorate inside the Ministry of Health.
Do targets work? You talked about targets back just prior to the last election, and I look back at what you were saying then. It's fairly similar to what you're saying now. And the Association of Salary Medical Specialists put out a media release. Now, we should say they're a union, right? They're the doctors' union, saying national health targets, no magic bullet. Do targets work?
Targets work.
Why?
They work because they focus attention, they focus resources, and they focus accountability. They hold me accountable, they hold providers accountable. If we look at that part of the system that I think is most struggling, which at the moment is emergency departments, and a big shout out to the ED docs and nurses who are on duty today, understaffed, working hard. Thank you for turning up today. But if we look there, their team, Dr. John Bonning, who was a spokesperson for ED, absolutely, unequivocally, we need to reintroduce or refocus health targets. They make a difference. And I'd put this to you. How do you think the COVID response went without health targets, by the way?
So what happens if people aren't meeting the health targets? What would National do?
So that's the accountability measure that I would have for myself as a potential overseer of the system, and the providers as well. But what we know is...
I don't understand what that means. The accountability measure equals what action?
The accountability means I'm accountable to the New Zealand public. I'm accountable to the leader. I'm accountable for that target.
So if the targets aren't being met, you as minister would do what?
I will then be in a position where I would need to redirect resources. I would expect that I would be answerable to my caucus, and I'll be answerable to New Zealanders. That's what accountability means.
Redirect resources, you mean spend more?
I would redirect resources from where I might not be getting effective spend. And
where is that, where you're not getting effective spend?
Oh, well, shall we start with the $20 million of vaccines that were put into the incinerator because they expired? The measles catch-up program, the botched measles catch-up program. $20 million for the expired vaccines, $30 million for the botched measles catch-up program. Those are just starting points. $486 million in health reform and layers and layers and layers of bureaucracy.
Will you attack the health bureaucracy?
I need a public service that has capacity. This is not an attack on the health bureaucracy at all. This is what this is a guideline, this is a direction of travel that I'll hold myself accountable for targets, and I will build the capacity to make sure that we achieve those targets.
Okay, so you're going to sigh through the health bureaucracy where you determine that it is not doing what it needs to do and is not providing value for money?
Where it's ineffective and not meeting outcomes.
It's still not enough to spend extra money, is it? On top of a tax cut. Is National standing by its tax cut? 39 cents in the dollar going for people over 180,000?
You've heard the Leader and the Finance Minister say we will stand by that position.
Can you do all of this? Can you spend and cut taxes?
Well, what we can do is we can raise the health budget every single year, and we've made a commitment to doing that. So people should be very reassured that you've heard the Leader and our finance spokesman say we will raise the health budget every single year.
Let's talk about getting a workforce. And I was just reading the interim government policy statement on health, which I know you will have read. Priority 4, which I know you will have agreed with, is developing the health workforce of the future. Why the hell don't we have a health workforce?
Yeah.
And let's set aside the immigrants. I'm talking about successive governments who haven't developed a health workforce.
Just by the way, that's an example of the layers of bureaucracy, because look at that as an accountability document. You start with a letter of expectation from the minister. then you have the interim government policy statement, then you have Health New Zealand's charter, then you have the health plan which was announced, and then a statement of performance expectations. Surely your statement is, we will stop people from getting ill, and if you're ill, we'll treat you in a timely and quality fashion, instead of all of these five documents. Different question, but just saying. You've asked about health workforce. All pathways at the moment tend to head towards health workforce. We're really struggling. We're struggling to retain, we're struggling to bring people, you know, into New Zealand. The health workforce has been a problem for many years, and in our hands as well, actually, even previously in government. We struggled with health workforce. COVID has sort of made it worse. There are solutions to health workforce that we could do today, though, John.
And they are?
Several things. First of all, there's three buckets in health workforce.
Do you want me to talk for a bit while you have a glass of water? I'm going to talk, and I'll tell you what I'm going to do while you have a glass of water, because there's nothing worse than having a frog in your throat. And that is, I want to say, so what you're saying, and I've seen the media releases that came out on Friday, I think, is that we need to get people in, right? We need to work to get nurses in to the country. But boy, this is a competitive market. Everyone's in the same position. So let's look at a graduate registered nurse in New Zealand, $60,000 a year. Same job in Australia, $80,000 a year. How the hell do we compete in a global market?
So several things. There's three buckets, three sets of levers that we can pull. The first is the offshore bucket. And that initially, that talks to retaining what we've got, which is around terms and conditions and wages and salaries. But then secondly, no one understands why we haven't turned on the day one pathway to residency for internationally qualified nurses. I just can't think of a rational example, neither can anyone else. We could do that today, it would cost you nothing. Do that today, turn that on.
Are you persuaded, I'm really interested in this, are you persuaded that that would be enough to get people to work for $20,000 a year less here than they can get in Australia?
It would be a contribution, because what they're saying to us is that pathway to residency is really important. But you raise a really valid point, and that's around retention component almost, as well as recruitment, for how we compare for wages and salary with Australia, for example.
What are we talking about?
Well, we never have, and I don't know if we're ever going to. It's our terms and conditions that people come to New Zealand. And unfortunately, the nurses look in at the moment, they see a pay sector freeze, they see a minister who's not collaborating well with his sector, they see what's called the Safer Nursing Accord, which means if you're on an orthopaedic ward, people can't readily turn themselves, you need a higher number of nurses. That was supposed to be deployed 100% by June last year. All they see is hard work and an unwelcoming environment. So we're not competing well with the Australias, the Canadas at the moment. We have a second bucket. There are hundreds of nurses, hundreds of doctors here who aren't able to register. How can that be? They live here, they're permanent, they're already contributing, but they're driving Uber Eats down Queen Street today. How can that be? We must be able to find a pathway. And then to come to your first point, we need to turn on our own homegrown, culturally competent pipeline, increase the medical intake, increase nursing intake.
I just want to tick a couple of things off before you go. Decide, which is the National Abortion Telehealth Service, right? So this is the government's National Abortion Telehealth Service, which gives people in the first 10 weeks of pregnancy access to clinical consultations, etc., over the phone, essentially. Will National continue to fund Decide?
Yes.
Full stop?
Yes.
No ifs, buts or maybes?
No ifs, buts. We have said that we will not change our abortion settings, and we believe in increasing access to health for New Zealanders, and this is a health access.
I want to go back to where we started. I just want to end on this, and I'm just hearing that my earpiece go shuffle, 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 which means I've gone long. But Te Whatu Ora Health New Zealand. Mm. Might you stick with that?
When we land, we will stay with it, because the sector has said don't do major structural change, but we'll be certainly more outcome focused than what it's projecting at the moment.
Dr. Shane Reti, I always enjoy talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate
it. Pleasure to speak with you too.
Yeah, John. Thank you for coming in.